Seorang anak Juriah Jalalus Syuti merasakan dia sudah menjalankan tanggungjawab sebagai seorang anak dengan menziarahi ibunya yang berusia 75 tahun dan tinggal berseorangan hampir setiap hari. Pernah suatu ketika dia melihat ibunya terkencing di dapur, namun menganggap keadaan itu adalah perkara biasa dan merasakan ibunya mampu menangani secara sendirian kerana dia tahu ibunya seorang yang berdikari. Hampir 6 bulan dia melihat masalah tersebut berterusan, namun mula menyedari apa yang dialami ibunya bukan sesuatu yang normal. Dia tahu ibunya malu untuk membincangkan masalah tersebut dengan anak-anak. Setiap hari Juriah terpaksa membersihkan lantai rumah ibunya kerana bau hancing dan kain batik yang dipakai ibunya juga perlu ditukar dengan lebih kerap kerana kebanyakan terkoyak akibat asid air kencing.
Mula-mula nampak masalah dia di mana kita saya nampak sendiri macam mana dia sering ada masalah bila datang rumah bau hancing, kain dia selalu bertukar, dia selalu pergi bilik air, lapik kaki dekat depan pintu bilik, lapik kaki pun selalu bertukar. So tanda-tanda tu dah ada, tapi sebab sekadar nampak saja. Tapi lepas yang beberapa bulan lepas tu ada satu kejadian yang mana bila dia cuba bangun dan berjalan ke bilik air, dia terus release kencing terus depan saya. So saya macam, kita dua-dua terkejut lah, kami berdua terkejut, mak terkejut, saya pun terkejut, tapi still tidak membincangkan tentang masalah itu. So ambil masa sedikit, lepas tu saya bincang dengan kakak macam mana tentang isu mak, kakak pun nampaklah masalah-masalah itu. So baru kita sedar, kita ni yang anak-anak ni yang sedar mak ada masalah. Sebab sebelum ni kita faham mak tu dia super mom, apa-apa semua dia boleh buat. Tapi sekarang kita rasa macam dia perlu bantuan. Sebab selama ni semua dia buat sendiri, tapi sekarang ni anak-anak perlu bantu dia.
Namun lain pula yang dinyatakan oleh Andrew Yap, ibunya sendiri yang sedar akan masalahnya yang dihadapinya itu.
My mom had a problem with incontinence mungkin about 15 years ago maybe. And at that time I was still quite young, maybe university age or maybe slightly pre-university age. And at that time she would have problems holding her urine in when she would go to exercise. So she first started wearing sanitary pads to try to contain the urine. But after that, even with, you know, one kind of trip of exercising, she would leak into her pants and her friends would started noticing. And then slowly it just got worse and worse, and finally she spoke to me about it eventually. When I first discovered it, it was probably about somewhere between 5 to 10 years ago. And it only got solved maybe like after I discovered it, maybe at least 3 or 4 years later, I think.
Perkongsian daripada Juriah dan Andrew itu bersempena pelancaran kempen Apa Khabar Mak Abah, anjuran TENA dan disokong Yayasan Continence Malaysia. Kempen bertujuan menggalakkan anak-anak untuk lebih prihatin dan mengambil berat tentang keadaan kesihatan ibu bapa masing-masing, terutamanya berkaitan masalah lemah pundi kencing atau incontinence.
As we get busy with our own lives, yeah, whether it's work or with family, we tend to overlook that our parents are also aging, and many of us are not aware of what they are going through. Yeah, and some of them could be suffering incontinence in silence.
Incontinence adalah keadaan apabila anda gagal mengawal kencing. Meskipun ia bukan penyakit yang boleh mengancam nyawa, terdapat pelbagai salah tanggapan terhadap masalah yang biasa dialami ini.
Well, urine incontinence is an involuntary loss of control of urine leakage, which you cannot control, which causes big social and medical problems for the patients to suffer. So very important to understand about incontinence because it's very, very common.
Namun, ramai yang percaya hanya golongan tua sahaja yang akan mengalaminya.
The most common kinds of incontinence are basically stress incontinence and urge incontinence. In stress incontinence, I'm sure you've had friends when they cough or they jog and a bit of urine comes out. That is stress incontinence. It's associated with giving birth to many children because of the weakness of the pelvic floor. The other one is overactive bladder. The overactive bladder is when you've got this desire, kerap kencing, you want to go, you know, you feel that you've got to go, but you cannot postpone. And you've got to, no matter where you are, you've got to run to the toilet. And if you don't run to the toilet on time, then you leak. So those are the two most common kinds of incontinence that happen in Malaysia. And our campaign is to educate people, especially young people who've got parents, because many of these parents will suffer from this, and they won't want to come forward for medical treatment. These things are all treatable, you know. You can take medications or advice or exercises, and it can reduce the suffering considerably.
Dianggarkan satu daripada tiga wanita Malaysia berusia 40 tahun ke atas dan satu daripada 10 lelaki berusia 60 tahun ke atas mengalami masalah ini. Sebanyak 1.4 juta rakyat Malaysia menghadapinya, namun hanya 31% sahaja yang mendapatkan rawatan. Tambahan lagi, masalah lemah pundi kencing boleh menjejaskan pergerakan dan kualiti hidup seseorang. Dengan itu, TENA menyediakan sumber maklumat serta penyelesaian holistik untuk membantu masalah lemah kawalan kencing seperti TENA Pants yang menyerupai seluar dalam yang memudahkan pergerakan dan memberi kebebasan untuk melakukan rutin harian tanpa risau.
So for TENA Pants, there is two absorbency. We have plus and value, different absorbency depending on the user's need, yeah, on the leakage, whether it's heavy or moderate leakage. And it is breathable. It's just like an underwear, very easy to wear and dispose. And they could just lead on their normal life.
Ini ditambah lagi dengan perasaan malu dan risau terhadap tanggapan buruk masyarakat membuatkan mereka tidak mahu berbincang tentang masalah ini.
Well, TENA is helpful. Why? Because they raise awareness. They are the awareness in the masyarakat because of urinary incontinence. Otherwise, people won't come forward, right? That's number one. And their pads are very good. They will be able to soak up urine and still maintain their skin dry. If the skin is not dry, it'll get red, infected with fungus, and then it'll break down.
Kita cuba banyak produk, kita banyak cubalah. Macam-macam, even produk pun dia ada banyak range dan dia cuba macam-macam. Tapi macam sebab dia tak susah nak bergerak kan, sebab dia duduk atas wheelchair. So, mula-mula dia try yang pakai yang jenis yang macam diapers kanak-kanak. Tapi macam dia kata susah nak pakai. So, kita cubalah range produk yang lain sampai TENA Pants. So, bila dia pakai TENA Pants, mak okey tak? Okey.
TENA menyediakan senarai semak diri dan buku panduan Caring 101 secara online dalam Facebook TENA Malaysia dan website TENA www.tena.com.my yang tertumpu kepada beberapa perubahan tingkah laku harian ibu bapa seperti terlalu kerap ke tandas atau tidak mahu menyertai aktiviti luar rumah dan memberi pandangan terhadap perubahan yang berlaku mengikut peringkat umur serta penyelesaian praktikal terbaik untuk menjaga ibu bapa.
With this whole campaign, we actually provide tools and resources to actually help the children, yeah, to identify some of the common signs, you know, in the change of the behavior of your parents that they could be suffering incontinence. The tools that we actually have, basically, the first one is a self-checklist. So there are 6 questions in there. Very simple. You take that that survey to see whether does your parents have incontinence. And then the next one is you actually have a Caring 101 handbook. In this handbook, we actually have a lot of practical solutions to actually help children and caregivers to manage incontinence better for with their parents. And we also have an online version, so you can actually download. You know, today a lot of young people, the children, they are always online. Yeah, if they do not want to read, so you can download it. And we have also some educational videos. So these videos actually show you very practical solutions, like for instance, how to bathe an incontinent person on the bed. Yeah, or how do you prevent bed sores? Or even as simple as how do you wear a diaper? Yeah, because it's different from a baby and an adult wearing a diaper. Of course, if your parents, they are mobile, they could actually use TENA Pants.
Berbekalkan pengetahuan ini, ahli keluarga diperkasakan untuk membantu ibu bapa mereka. Mungkin dengan cara memulakan perbincangan, membeli seluar dalam penyerap tena pants atau mendapatkan nasihat perubatan supaya orang tersayang dapat terus melakukan perkara yang mereka gemari dan menjalani kehidupan secara bebas dan berkeyakinan tanpa rasa risau tentang masalah incontinence.
Macam saya sebab mula-mula kita, saya rasa macam saya sendiri in denial sebab tahu mak ada masalah jantung. So bila ada masalah jantung, dia punya apa, dia memang ada masalah untuk selalu kerap kencing kan. Tapi selepas itu bila kita tengok memang itu yang menyebabkan dia ada masalah, then baru kita bincang, baru kita lepas agak lama baru kita bincang. Tapi macam saya cadangkan untuk anak-anak yang lain, kalau dah nampak tanda-tanda tu, memang perlu bincang dulu dengan mak sebab itu diri dia. So mungkin selama ni dia dah memang biasa hidup aktif, tiba-tiba dia diam. Kadang-kadang kita rasa, kita ingatkan dia hanyalah mood dah orang-orang tua, dah mood dia dah pergi ke arah lain. Tapi sebenarnya macam mak saya, kes mak saya, lepas kita jumpa solution untuk masalah incontinence dia, dia dah lebih aktif sekarang dan dia lebih gembira, nampak kegembiraan dia tu dan dia sangat excited untuk pergi ke mana-mana. So anything, bincang dengan mak, identify masalah tu dan cari jalan penyelesaian macam mana nak selesaikan. Bukan nampak tanpa berfikir betul-betul apa masalah yang sedang dihadapi oleh mak.
Go and see a urologist and then they'll be able to assess. Kalau they will teach how to do bladder training or take medication, and she'll be very much better.
I really, really hope, you know, that we could do something today, and I hope that everybody learns something, and we should be more observant of changes of behavior in our parents because they are also aging, and a lot of us are always very busy, yeah, but then we should not forget that they took care of us when we were young, yeah, so it is time that we really support them when they really need it.